Shri Guru Charitra, Chapter 12. Narahari taken to Sannyasa. In this chapter, Narahari, Amba's son, gives spiritual instruction to his mother. He blesses her that she would have two more sons within a year and one more son and daughter later. After the birth of the two sons, twins, Narahari leaves home for Kasi. He was hardly 9 years old at that time. At Kasi, he took initiation into Sannyasa Ashrama from Krishna Saraswati and took the name of Narasimha Saraswati. After that, he went to Badrikashrama and visited many holy places. Siddha Yogi continued the narration. Narahari explained to his mother the higher philosophy of life. She had tried to tell him earlier that one should not skip the responsibilities of the household. One should pass through the prescribed stages of life in sequential order. The ashrama dharma, after grihastha ashrama only, which mellows man, his senses having been appeased, should one take to vanaprastha or sannyasa. And not before that. Narahari revealed to his mother that he was not a normal mortal being who has to necessarily go through all the stages of life. Everyone has his own adhikara and one has to decide for himself his course of life using his discrimination properly. He continued with his observation saying, life is like a bubble. Death might knock at any time and snatch us away. Every moment of human life is precious and is a God-gifted opportunity for man to regenerate himself spiritually and speed up to the blessed state of self-realization. In the earlier yugas, man's life was long. The stages of life prescribed by the Shastras were all right for them, but in the Kali Yuga, men have only a short span of life and do not have the longevity of the earlier yugas. If one goes through life slowly, without taking to the pursuit of higher purposes of life, and if his life is cut short early, isn't this birth futile? One should cultivate vairagya towards worldly pleasures from early stages of life. One should not fritter away his energies in human foibles. The world is illusory. If one doesn't use discrimination and does not cultivate vairagya, he would sink into the mire of samsara and will let go the precious life to waste. One should set his mind on the goal of life and strive to achieve it from the early stages of life, because who knows when he will be snatched away by death. Losing this life without realization of God will be the greatest tragedy for man. The mother realized that the spiritual fire raging in her son cannot be smothered and that her motherly love and attachment should not be let to hold him back from his quest for the infinite. However, she pleaded with him to stay at home for at least a few more years till she had another child. Narahari agreed to it and said that she would have 4 more children, 3 sons and 1 daughter. A year later, Amba Bhavani had twins. 2 sons were born to her, and then she yielded to let Narahari leave the home. While bidding farewell, touched by the tears of the parents, Narahari said, Whenever you think of me and want me to be with you, wherever I may be, you will have my darshan. He told them again that they would have 1 more son and also a daughter. With these consoling words to his parents, young Narahari, who was hardly in his 9th year at that time, left his home and set out on his spiritual quest. The entire village bade a tearful farewell, just as it happened to Krishna and Balarama when they left Vrindavan for Mathura. Narahari came to Varanasi, the spiritual center of Bharat. Every day after taking his bath in the sacred waters of the Ganges, he used to worship Kasi Vishveshwara 3 times a day. At Kasi, he came in contact with Sri Krishna Saraswati, a highly advanced yogi and a fully realized soul. Narahari requested Sri Krishna Saraswati to initiate him into the Sannyasa Ashrama. Sri Krishna Saraswati was pleased at the devotion, the austere discipline and earnestness of Narahari, and much more so with his intellectual brilliance and scriptural knowledge. Krishna Saraswati recognized in him a future savant of the spiritual culture of the country, and especially one who was going to glorify the supremacy of the Sannyasa Ashrama again, as was earlier done by Sri Adi Shankaracharya of Kaladi. He was immensely happy to have Narahari as his disciple and to initiate him into sannyasa. Narahari was given by him the new name of Narasimha Saraswati. Namdharak interrupted Siddha Yogi and asked why Narahari, God incarnate himself, needed a guru and why should he go through the formality of initiation. Siddhamuni said, Guru is a link between God and embodied being, even though the latter may have been a divine incarnation. Sri Rama had Vasishtha Rishi as Guru and Sri Krishna had Sandipani Rishi as his Guru. He gave a glorious account of the Guru Parampara originating with Lord Shankara himself. Shankara, Vishnu, Brahma, Vasishtha, Shakti, Parasara, Vyasa, Shuka, Gaudapada, Govindacharya, Shankara, Bhagavatapada. Thus flows the glorious Guru Parampara, said Siddha Yogi. Siddha Yogi explained that for spreading true knowledge for the enlightenment and welfare of all, Sri Narasimha Saraswati conducted a number of Jnana Yajnas by discoursing and giving sermons going from place to place around Varanasi. Hundreds of people were guided on the spiritual path by him. A number of them became his disciples. From Varanasi, Narasimha Saraswati went to Badrikashram forest with his disciples. Then he moved from place to place and arrived at Ganga Sagar near Calcutta. Travelling along the banks of the holy river, he reached Prayaga, Triveni, the holy confluence of the sacred rivers Ganga, Yamuna and subterranean Saraswati. He initiated one Madhava Saraswati into sannyasa at the holy Prayaga. Thus ends the 12th chapter of Sri Guru Charitra, describing the glorious Guru Parampara that nourished and sustained the perennial flow of spiritual wisdom, Jnana Ganga, in the holy and blessed land of Bharat Desha. Glory to the all-merciful, the omnipresent, and the ever-responsive Guru Nath.